Hi, Su-Lynn. For this tutorial, we're going to look at rigging. We're going to build a head. We're going to look at invert cutting. So the assets you're going to need are going to be a face, an eye, and we're going to need to separate out the layers. Here is a rig that I've already made, and we're going to start from the beginning and break it down. Here we have a face, and what we need to do is also to have a pupil, which is separated out from the eye. If we go to the drawing layer, we can see the pupil is on a separate layer, and also we need to put color in the correct way to separate out the line art and also the color art. So not to forget to use the technique of putting your drawing on the line art layer and then dropping in color on the color art layer. Similarly with the eye, we also have the line art and then the color art. So if we go back to the camera, we can see it there. So we're going to start with just rigging the eye. On the node view, you can see my drawings that I've already prepared. So the first thing to do is to add a peg. So we're going to just select, put in pegs. A great way to put in the rotation point so that the rotation point is in a similar area is just to select the pegs and then just go in with one position for instance, the eye. And then what will happen is when you select the pupil, it's already in a close by position for you just to shift that to the rotation point for the eye. So that's just something to keep in mind so that you're not always constantly having to drag the rotation point. The node library is a great one to use if you're not really familiar with your nodes yet, because you've got the images. And there's different ways to view it as well. So at the moment, it's on the default setting. You can also have it as a list. And then this one's nice as well because this also has descriptions as well. So you can see cutter here and it explains what the cutter is. It cuts out a portion of the image using a matte drawing. And this is going to be a very, very useful node to become familiar with, to use. There's also ways of grouping, so you can add things to your favorites. And obviously the cutter is one of the favorites because it's one of the most used nodes for rigging. If you're using the node library, you can just click and drag it up, as I've shown you. I like the new way, so it's just hitting return or enter, putting in the first two letters usually does the trick, and then just clicking on the node you need. So that's one way of doing it. If you want it to come attached, if you know where you want it, then you can actually select the drawing node in advance and then hit return a key. Again, by default, it recognizes the last node that you've looked up. If I click on that, it attaches it straight away to my connector under the pupil. Now let's go ahead and get our other node. So we need a line art. So I'm going to leave that there for now. And then we also need a color art. It just needs disconnecting if it does connect. What we know of the eye is that it is made up of line art and color art. With that information in mind, we know that if we connect color art to the eye and we use that to cut the pupil, that means it's going to create this mask. Now, what's happened is the pupils disappeared, and that's because we need to invert. So this is what we call invert cutting. You can do it two ways. You can open up the properties and just check inverted, and we can see it's already popped in. Or we can just double click on the mask and that also works. We already have that made. And what we can do now is to check how that's working. And if we move the pupil now around the eye, we can see it stays within the area of the eye, the color art of the eye, because it's been cut by it. Now, if I zoom in, what you're seeing as well is there's a difference in the line. So just to make that a little more perfect and consistent in terms of the line art, we're going to connect the line art again to the eye, and then we're going to take a connector and place it on top of the connector for the pupil, and we can already see it pops in and has a consistent line. If I take or select the peg for the eye and move it around, it's really nice because we're not having to position it so it stays within the eyeball. If I disconnected that, and let me just take that back to the original position. So if I take out the invert cutting and then I took my pupil or selected the pupil peg again and then try to do the same, we can see it's now not staying within the parameters of the color art of the eyeball. Let me disconnect that as well. And you can see how tricky it would be if I was animating it and trying to make sure it stayed within there and having to make sure that I'm not going to go over in certain frames. That is our first bit of rigging, and it's called invert cutting.